Hello dear children, welcome again to my class. Today we will be completing the second stanza of the poem. I have written the stanza here for you, but I will be reading from the book as I did it previously, right? So let's start the explanation part. You can see it from here, but I'll be reading for you from the book itself, okay? When Ajax strives some rock's vast weight to throw, the line too labors and the words move slow, right? Now, yes, students, one more thing I would like to tell that ancient Greek, okay, that is ancient Greek gods or ancient Greek heroes or the mythology from Greece itself, it have played a very important role while creating a poem or while making a drama or anything like that, okay? So, the writers like Alexander Pope or William Shakespeare, you can say John Milton, John Keats, there are so many writers, so many poets who have adopted the Greek culture, you know? You can see the Greek culture in their written work, that is in their poems or in their dramas, in their novels, etc., etc. Okay, so here also you can see this word Ajax, Camellia, Timotheus are connected with the Greek culture. Now here Ajax is, in your book you have been given a Greek warrior, right? So Ajax is a Greek warrior. Now here students, what I am trying to tell is that Alexander Pope have told that the word selection should be very good. It means that the graph of the words and the graph of the sound should match each other, right? Excuse me. Should match each other means what? Now here Ajax is what? A Greek soldier. Okay, a warrior, Greek warrior. So he is also considered as a hero, right? A strong hero in the Greek culture or Greek mythology. Here what I mean to say is when this word Ajax itself come, it means that we are talking about someone who is very strong enough. So the writer, that is Alexander Pope, is saying, just imagine, okay, he is telling to his fellow mates or his fellow writers or the fellow poets or different kinds of poets, he is just telling us that you just imagine that Ajax, that is the man, the strong warrior who strives some rock's vast weight to throw. Now, he is telling that, just imagine that Ajax have carried a rock, okay, he have carried a rock and he have to throw that rock, right? He have to throw that rock. Now, if I'm carrying this marker, obviously, I can throw it like this, right? I can throw it like this. But in case if I'm carrying a rock, that is a very big piece of what? A stone. That is rock. If I'm carrying that big rock, do you really think that I can throw that rock very swiftly like this as I threw the marker? No, nobody can do it, right? It is very tough task, and I can say it is next to impossible. But what the Alexander Pope is trying to tell, that when a person like Ajax, okay, because we are telling about Ajax because he's a very strong warrior, okay, in the Greek mythology. Now Alexander Pope is saying ki, suppose or just imagine that Ajax is throwing a rock. Now from year till year, what exactly is done? It is efforts, that is the struggle. Whose struggle? Struggle of Ajax. He is struggling to throw that particular rock. Okay, so this struggle is what the outcome of what exactly Ajax want to do or he is representing, right? So he is saying now this word strives, right? This word strives itself have that tendency that how exactly the struggle might be. It means that when you are telling somebody or when the word selection is like that, for example, if I say Ajax was a man and he is throwing the rock very swiftly. Now, can you just digest this, that throwing a rock and that too swiftly? No, we cannot digest this. But when the word strives itself come, it means struggles, right? So when the word strive come, it means what? It means that yes, with the strenuous effort, Ajax might have threw the rock, right? So the word selection should also be like that. It means that when you represent or when you write or when you make a reader note that the word is symbolizing a struggle or swiftness or softness, then the selection of that sound and word should be equal to each other. It should not be different. Okay, let's come to the next line. Not so when swift camellia scores the plain, flies over the unbending corn and skims along the main. Now hear this word, camellia. Now who is camellia? Camellia, basically she is also a lady warrior in the Greek mythology, and she is considered for her swiftness. It is also that said that when she used to run on the water, yes, when she used to run on the water, she used to run so swiftly that her feet would not be wet. Okay, like she used to run so softly. And it is also said that when she used to run on the corn, the farm of corn, you can say, right? So she used to be so swift that she did not even bend. Okay, you cannot even imagine a girl like camellia. So here the word camellia represent whom? It represent a girl in Roman mythology who was so swift that she could run over a field of corn without bending one blade. Okay, so here what Alexander Pope is trying to tell I am not saying you to become like Ajax. That is, I am not saying you to have the quality where you select strong words or struggling words only. No. Neither am I saying you to select swift words or soft words. No. But whatever the selection of the word is, right, it should be very systematic and it should follow the rhythm as well as the sound of what exactly the poem is rhymed up like. Okay. So here he is just trying to say this, that it is not necessary. Now, if I say camellia, now obviously I have given the introduction of who she was. Now, if I say she used to struggle a lot while roaming on the field, cornfield, or she used to bend herself while roaming on the cornfield, it will not match. Why? Because this word camellia itself is stating that she was a Greek lady who was known for her swiftness. Okay, so we cannot use words like struggle or harsh, rough, right, stiff. These words cannot suit this personality, that is camellia. What suits her is swiftness. So here Alexander Pope is trying to say that it is the choice of the poet to choose the word, but the chosen word should be systematically balanced with the rhythm and the what sound. Thus this art will make what the definite best of the poems. Okay, now here how Timothy's varied poem surprise and bid alternate passions fall and rise. Now here you can see fall and rise, but this we often comes to know that it is always said rise and fall. Okay, first it is rise and then fall, that is rise and fall. It cannot be fall and rise. Okay, fall and rise is not a word, but just to rhyme up this thing, Alexander Pope is using. Now this surprise and rise, that is surprise and fall and rise itself shows that how systematically the arrangement of words is done by Alexander Pope. By this only we can come to know. Okay, let's come to the explanation of this couplet. Hear how Timothy's varied poem surprise and bid alternate passions pull and rise. Now who is Timothy's? Again, as I told you that this poem or any poet have a certain you can say texture or balance or like a glimpse of the old Roman mythology, Greek mythology, and characters from that particular mythology, right? So here Timothy is also one of the most important poet in ancient Greece. Now this poet was musician also, okay, and he was musician and poet in whose court? In Alexander's court. Okay. Yes, Alexander's court, not this Alexander. Okay, in Alexander's court. Now here he is saying that the selection of the words and the rhyming of the poem should be systematic as the music or the rhyming of whom? Of Timothy's. Why? He was the great musician and the great poet. He was known for his music because he used to synchronize the music very nicely, and well balanced music was born by his talent. Okay, right? I hope you are trying to get my point. Now, he was a very good composer. That is, he used to compose definite parameters of music as well as definite parameters of the poems, whatever he used to write. Okay. Now, the writer, that is Alexander Pope, is saying that a poet should get knowledge from whom? From this character. Why? Because he was perfect. He was a perfect person who used to do perfect things. That is, if he used to write some keynotes of music, or if he used to make some music or compose some music, it was perfect. There was no one to take out any kind of mistake from that particular music. And in case if he used to write poems also, nobody could have doubted or nobody could have raised any kind of questions from his poems. Why? Because the arrangement, the synchronization, the rhyming, the choosing of the word, the selection base, everything was very systematic, that it was very fair, it was clean, neat and very swift. The synchronization of the words, that is the modulation of the words, were so good that nobody could raise the question on whose work, on Timothy's work. So Alexander Pope is saying that one, that is the poet, a learner, or the poet who is writing any kind of poem, should adopt that kind of quality from whom? From Timothy's. Although he is just an imagination or a character in that Roman culture, but yet Alexander Pope is paying attention on this word, that is Timotheus. Why? Because he wants the poets, the new poets or poetess, to adopt those rules, to adopt those qualities of how Timotheus, those qualities that Timotheus used, so that you can also use those qualities in writing your poems and glorify the meaning of what? The meaning of poem. So here, students, you can also see one more word, that is alternate passions. What is alternate passion? Alternate passions means different emotions, right? Different emotions. Now, why Alexander Pope is using this word alternate passions? He is using this word alternate passions because when Timotheus used to write something, okay, he used to write it according to the balance and emotions. That is, it cannot be that I am happy, I'll be happy forever. No. If I am sad, I'll be sad forever. No. If I am the feeling of melancholy, no, it cannot be forever. It changes, right? So the emotion changes, and so has to the word also. That is, the word should also change according to the emotions, right? As example I gave you, when you are showing something like struggling, you have to use words like it really means, right, that a person is doing struggle, right? And when you are showing something like happy, the word should match the particular situation. That is, when you are showing something as a happy content, it should be what the word, the choosing, that is the selection of the word, should be matching with what exactly you are trying to show. Thus, Timotheus was like that. Timotheus, you know, the frequency of his music was also like that. When the frequency of the music was high, the note was high. When it came down, the note was down. Thus, who is using? Alexander Pope is saying, and bid alternate passions fall and rise, right? So, students, I hope this is clear to you. Thank you for watching. Keep tuning to my class. Thank you and have a nice day.